either. First of all, I didn't choose to be a candy corn. It's how I was made, so don't judge. Second, on behalf of sugary treats everywhere, I need to clear something up. The fact that sugar makes kids hyperactive, it's not actually a fact. It's a myth. I know, why should you believe me? I'm made of sugar, but I'm not just a candy corn. I'm a candy corn with peer-reviewed research. It is a myth, disconfirmed by numerous studies, that sugar consumption causes hyperactivity or other behavior problems in children or adults. If you find that hard to believe, first of all, I've cited all of this research in the description below. Check it out for yourself. And second of all, you're not alone. Most people do think sugar makes kids hyperactive. Why? Something called confirmation bias, which is our tendency to pay attention to stuff that supports what we already believe and ignore stuff that doesn't. Here's how it works. Probably at some point in your life, somebody told you that sugar makes kids hyperactive. Now, since then, you've probably been in a bunch of situations where sugar didn't seem to affect a kid, but you didn't think about it. You may not have even noticed. Then, at some point, you see a kid eating a birthday cake. Kid starts bouncing off the walls, your brain makes a connection. Aha! It must have been all that sugar. Even though there are a lot of reasons that kid could have been bouncing off the walls. Loud music, lots of presents, all of his friends in one room. It's exciting. Or maybe this is the first time he's gotten to have cake in a super long time and he's really happy about it. Or maybe he has ADHD and he's like that like 90% of the time. But your brain decided it was sugar because you've heard that sugar makes kids hyperactive. Confirmation bias. Then you point it out to another parent, they nod their head in agreement, and bam, social reinforcement of that bias. Look, confirmation bias is totally normal. We all do it, even scientists, which is why the gold standard for research is a double-blind study, in which neither the participants nor the experimenters know who is receiving a particular treatment. Studies like this one, on boys who were specifically chosen for the study because their moms said they were behaviorally sensitive to sugar. One group of moms was told their boys were given sugar, and the other group of moms were told their boys were given a sugar-free placebo. After interacting with them, the moms who were told their kids were given sugar rated their kids as being significantly more hyperactive than did the moms who were told that it was a placebo, even though nobody got sugar. All the boys had been given the placebo. Turns out, confirmation bias doesn't only make us assume causes for behavior, it can also make us imagine that behavior. But it's harmless, right? Sometimes. If I think every time I wear purple, people look at me funny, so I stop wearing purple, I'm not really hurting anybody. But in this case, confirmation bias is often why parents, especially parents of kids with a hyperactive presentation of ADHD, are judged for their children's behavior just because they gave them a popsicle. Which, come on guys, isn't cool. To them, or to sweet treats like me who get put in timeout because Jimmy did something wrong. Because, you know, candy corn. Look, I'm not saying you should give your kid a chocolate factory. We've seen how that turns out. Too much sugar can cause plenty of issues. Tooth decay, obesity, diabetes. Diets chronically high in sugar can be harmful to your body, and that includes your brain. So it is important to enjoy sugar in moderation. And there may even be cases where sugar sensitivity really is a problem for your child and not just something you're prone to believe due to confirmation bias. So if you're concerned, it's not a bad idea to see a licensed nutritionist or dietitian. But convincing another parent or yourself to self-treat ADHD by eliminating sugar is harmful. Giving a kid an occasional piece of candy doesn't create hyperactivity, and taking it away won't cure it. But we do know perpetuating myths like sugar causes hyperactivity makes parents of ADHD kids less likely to pursue treatment options that actually help. And that's not confirmation bias, that's research. If you're still not convinced, remember that overly restricting a kid's access to sugar can not only create frustrating battles at home, it can make them more likely to overdo it when they do have access to it, which for brains that are already prone to overdoing things can be super counterproductive. So as long as sugar isn't all they're eating and they don't have a condition that is affected by a little sugar, go ahead, let your kid enjoy a piece of candy and don't let anybody make you feel guilty about it. Then remind them to brush their teeth. Happy Halloween. Oh, and remember, for safety purposes, avoid Halloween candy that is not wrapped. Stay safe. By the way, for those of you who are thinking, she's a candy corn, clearly a chill for big sugar. This video is sponsored only by the incredible people who support How to ADHD on Patreon, such as these brain advocates. Thanks to all my Patreon brains for making unsponsored, research-based content like this possible. Candy kisses!